Let's go right to the phones. Jedi fan, before we jump into Destiny, I'm going to give you my fullest attention.
I'm going to get a Euro.
Rocco's getting a Euro. Do you ever, when you were a kid, do you ever make this noise?
A little bit. Not a whole lot.
One sounds better. You got digital or you got full analog human interface device? Kevin? That's pretty good. What do you think, Rob?
I like the full analog a little bit better.
Full analog. All right. Me and Kevin, yeah. Maybe we could do like a harmony later.
Yeah.
Or we could eat some hominy. Isn't that a bean?
I think so.
Who knows these things? Rob, we got all kinds of titles on screen. We got all kinds of distractions going on, but I'm going to cut right back into my pretty little self. I found a little alcove here in Destiny. Myself as the star child likes to sit at the tower, and I've got my own little personal balcony here. No one ever even comes and fucks with me. You could even extend it out and hang out down here, but... Yeah, it's tucked away on this little part of the tower, if you can see. I guess I've given the location away. So come and join me, fellow players, and we'll go on a strike team.
Is there a pool of water you can jump into, like Crackdown?
No Crackdown water. Oh. No. Sadly. So how are you doing, Rob? Yeah, I know you were out there protesting. You're out there doing the greater good for us.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you saw that. Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about what you're out there stopping traffic in New York City for.
It wasn't really stopping traffic because it was all organized.
Well, you didn't listen to Howard that day. I mean, he was quite upset at the traffic getting into the city.
Oh, he was? I don't really listen to Howard Stern that much.
He did. He specifically in past years, I know he's given the Puerto Ricans a hard time for their parade. He's given a lot of the groups their parades a hard time because it does impede the flow of traffic in and out of the city of Manhattan. But he gave the environment a pass, and he said that at least it's for a good cause. So what exactly was this good cause?
It was called the People's Climate March. It was one of many different like marches that were happening around the world around the same time, I guess.
All right, and you looked a bit like a Ninja Turtle in your Mega64 t-shirt.
Yeah. I actually joined up with a bunch of NYU.
Yeah.
A bunch of NYU students beforehand, and we all went together as a group. And some of them were putting on like, you know, sort of like green paint, I guess, for those who, I guess, I don't know.
Green is that for the cause? The green is the color of the cause?
Yeah, I guess like solidarity, you know.
Not medical marijuana freedom. That's usually what green. That's how I associate green. You see that big green cross out here on in California? You know what they sell in there?
Hell yeah!
Contacting Destiny servers seems to be some issues. We are dropping quite a bit of frames here in the XSplit window. Man, oh man, oh Shevitz. Here we go. Warlocks. Well, we'll get it right one of these days. Until then, I will continue to try to take calls. Wouldn't mind talking to, I know my dear sweetie Cody's calling in. Love to hear from him. Love to hear from some of you guys that are also playing Destiny. Maybe you could jump into the fire team with me. Join me online and let's play together. Let's see how it goes. But for now, Rob is calling back. Rob.
Hey.
I think we're having. I think it's issues over here at the Mega64 studios. In fact.
It's all good, man. It's all good.
It's all over the place. But yeah. What did you want to get to today?
What did I want to get to today? My question tonight, every Wednesday night, my editing class and all that.
Yeah.
And we talk about editing of certain movies and stuff like that. So I guess for you guys and everyone, including Rocco, if he's able to answer it, what is a movie for you that has really stood out in terms of like the editing?
Well, it's interesting because once you kind of start working on making video, whether it be, you know, film or television or YouTube in our case, or whatever, once you really get to sit down and start using editing software and everything, like, you can definitely, you have insight and you can see into the production of shows and movies and YouTube videos and all that stuff. I don't know, editing wise, I don't know if something stands out above and beyond for me. I mean, I have favorite films that I assume are well edited as well. Rocco might have a better answer at this since he does so much editing. Yeah. But he sadly went off to go get Euro. Do you eat Euro?
No, not really.
You don't have Euro?
I condemn you to living death.
Okay, you're missing out. But,
I think the only editing that stands out to me is bad editing.
Bad editing.
Then, you know immediately, like, oh, this is edited bad. But when it's good, you don't even notice.
Well, you know, and hats off to Tim and Eric because they gave... I would give it, I guess, shouts out to the editing in Aqua Teen Hunger Force. That was something that saved what otherwise is a pretty ugly show, I would assume. This fucking game is, like, not working. We're having internet issues. Dropping frames, yeah. Can't connect to the Destiny servers. Calls dropped again with Rob. He's back.
I'm back.
Hey, okay. Rocco, do you have a film that stands out as being, like, well edited?
Any of David Fincher's movies I think are really well edited.
Yeah, absolutely.
David Fincher, alright.
Yeah.
Fight Club, Requiem for... No, was Requiem his?
No.
That
no.
was Darren Aronofsky.
That's Aronofsky, yeah. What else did Fincher do? Social Network?
Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
Girl Interrupted?
No.
Is that what you said, Rob? What did you just say?
The girl with the dragon
tattoo. Oh, girl with the dragon tattoo, not Girl Interrupted. Yeah, I liked Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
Yeah. That's in terms of editing, that won the Academy Award for editing, and it was really stylistic.
Hell yeah. Shouts out.
And Social Network won the Academy Award for best editing too, so Fincher's movies really definitely stand out in terms of editing.
In terms of well edited masterpieces.
Yeah, absolutely. I think all his movies. I think he really has that editor's mindset when he's shooting of, I'm going to shoot it in this way, so when I go into the editing room, I can really construct this scene or the whole movie really in a certain style, and I think he really nails that style.
That's
really,
cool.
Well, really, really well.
And I bet when you're working on something, it's inspiring to see how he makes his cuts and where he places cameras and stuff like that.
Absolutely.
That's cool. So he directs and edits his films, or did he?
No. I mean, he definitely works with his editors a lot. He has two editors that he works with a lot: Kirk Baxter and Angus Wall.
Yeah, project is project. So nothing's really kind of working, and I don't know. Maybe it's you, Rob. Maybe you're the weak link.
Maybe I am the weakest link.
I don't know.
Maybe you should try another caller and see.
I'll try to just connect with no calls and let's see if I can get in on maybe I should not try the multiplayer. Let's just go to like boring ass
campaign. Yeah,
Venus is pretty. I'll do let's just load some patrol on Venus, see if I can at least land and fly that sparrow around. Thanks, Rob.
No problem, guys.
We sure do love you. We'll see you next time.
You have a good time. Hope things get better with the connection and everything.
I think so. Thank you, Rob. All right.